那同吗？今天，俺觉得顺便继续扫码了大地，旁边电线面给继续听，给不听？
这
啊，
是
够了呀，KTV 了，先生，
during the
我这
eighth
里继续
audio
听完，
chamber
还没给
spring dharma
你
teachings for
pass
the
电视剧，
nuns.
电视不行，
And
全部
so I'd
飞
like to
了，
offer
我
my
给儿
greetings
子，
to Drupin Dejan Rinpoche, as well as
专门也管不看的配备给，专门看的配备给大儿子，专门拿到连接的，
All of the nuns who have
我
come
看的
from our
信
Kagyu
息，
nunneries.
就查他们群的信息难给，
As
没
well as
给的
everyone
是，
else who is, all the other Sangha members
这
who
地
are
方
watching
这
over
地
the
方不，就
webcast,
他们老俩，
the monks
还
and
有
nuns,
我们三位，甚至全都行。
I'd like to wish you
那
all,
在这里呀，
express my greetings to you all. I hope you are
那就准
well.
备继续
So
听
this
到第二
evening,
天的，卡上了堂不，那就给是忙不全部的，那你送去了他的钱呢？要啊，该
So
是
this
不
year
给是忙不
we
全部的，
had a lot of
我送去
discussion
三天，
about
他
what
去，
teaching would be best to give during
我
the
就给
spring
买
teachings
鸭
this year.
子，羊
And
肝
some
切
people thought,
给
well,
算
maybe
了，
if we speak about the 7 points of mind training.
就加些辣的，说明
Others
什么意
said,
思？
maybe you could teach about the 37 practices of a
那
bodhisattva.
两颗线送礼呢？他不能不切给，他不要太艰
And
险
some
了。
people said that maybe you should teach from
那
the
他先
ornament
送
of
礼，
precious liberation
不
by
是太危险
Kampopa.
了。
And other people said maybe the
那不
precious
送礼
garland of
去，
the Supreme
那
Path.
电
So
脑
there are
呢？
many people who said such things. And among them,
俺俩给个什么罪的？俺哪能行？
my
我们
own
辛苦
personal
做的呀。
opinion,
俺那老板工资不是写别的，我们多谢谢，
I
直接
thought,
给，
I said,
俺少
maybe
点
if
便宜
we
的
had
呀。
teachings on the 50 verses of the Guru,
便宜
on
都
the
差不多
Guru,
的呀，俺
and
那
in the
老板工资
end,
吧，写的不都是这些，
we
出名的。
decided that we would teach on the 50 verses on the Guru.
他这档给的老板工资吧，啥的，嘛，他可能给钱多，给钱写比那的，
If you
钱
think
可能
about
给
these
大的
50
多。
verses of on the Guru, it's like the
那
title
第二
actually
就老板
teaches
工
the
具吧，第
meaning.
三呢，对吧？就
When you
是
say
通过前
50
面这个
verses on the
老板工具
Guru,
的设计需要的。
there's
第二个
a
的呀，
text called
老
The
板工具吧，第二
Elucidation
个
of the
吧，
50
前面
Verses of
这
the
些
Guru
嘛，
by
都要。
Jetsun Drapa Gyaltsen. And when he explains the meaning
那
of the
老板工
title,
具吧，写下兄弟给老板念吧，写
he
呗。
says that the
老
title
板工
of
具
the 50 stanzas on the
念给
Guru
给啥？第一个
is
字念
called
呗，
this because
那
the
老板工具
stanza is
吧，写
50
下。
stanzas on the methods for
那
pleasing
老板
the
工具
Guru.
吧，
This is why
这
it is
档
called the 50 stanzas
老
on the
板工具
Guru.
吧，写给熊科长给陈科长给，那
So the
这
title
哪
of
里有
this
定义？
text actually teaches the
它的
meaning
定义
of the
要是这
text.
样呢？
What
老
it
板工具吧，
teaches
写给
is
啥
that
呢？老板
when we
定
say
义，
50 verses on the Guru, we're talking about
这
how to
档个老
follow
板
the
工具，
Guru.
第哪呢？每次都跟
How
别
to
的呀，
follow the Guru in
那个
general
上阿
and in
给同
particular,
上阿给，
how we should do it
老
in
板工作面，
particular in relation
这
个
个
to
上
the
阿
Vajrayana.
中间过了呀，
What is the
嘛，
way that the connections should be made
那
between
是
student
中间
and
略微第
master
三呢，
disciple
那就
in
过去
the
那个
Vajrayana?
上阿给，这确定这么一吧，上阿给举，就上阿旺的。龙胆，明阿拉说，他今天给就劝这个对吧？今天给那么多老板
He
娘们
talks
过
about
去呀，
the
这不相当看这一把。
connection, how to
那
make a
我
connection between the
这
master
用
disciple in
上阿
terms of
给，
Vajrayana, in
对
terms
他
of
们呀，
receiving的
劝这个老
empowerments
板
and
娘们，
transmissions and so
那
forth.
么上
Then, in
阿让
particular, it
老
speaks
板
about
定制
how a
呀，
student
那
who
让给
has
老板
entered
念
the
不起，
Vajrayana should
到底
follow the
必须
Guru,
老
or
板
the
工作去
methods they
怎
should
样弄
use
啊？坚
to
持了一张，
please the
这地
Guru.
方在
And
那样，
because
老板
this is
工作
taught
是
in
免费
50
的，这地
verses,
方多。
it is called the 50
这
stanzas
样，
on the
他就那
Guru.
么定制下的这档给，
So when we talk about the ways to follow a guru,
就那么三个，他念的档是漂亮用的了，晓得不？
the
另外那
Tibetan
些
word
的呢，
for
他
it is
档
lama.
三的，他念的肯定全部
This
是别的
word,
呢。那个
the
鸭
term
给，
lama came from the
里家给咕噜三，第一
Sanskrit
配
word
档
guru.
给，配配给了去吞咕噜钱用的啥呢？那
And
那
when
那
you
么三的，
translate
这听的差一步了，
that word, the
缺
term,
少
the
的。
meaning into
那么三
Tibetan,
个
you
给
get the
我，
word
那
lama.
些
So
离家
the
给的么着，离家给我了
source
三
for the word lama is the Sanskrit word guru, it seems.
다디 라마 세아텔라 단 드셰 구루 세아텔라 탄다 망보 드시 껴여서 봐 아니
Now, there are many different
고레
explanations we can
디시라
give of the
지시라
word guru.
구루
One
세아
that we
지고
often
텐데 지고
say is that
지고
guru
세아
means heaviness, and heavy here
아
means
샬란 지고 사부예 봐아
it's
딘데기
like when
딘데기
you
지고
have a
사부예
heavy
네
thing.
아메리칸 딜리아 소
And to
아니 지고
hear what it
유엔에 인지
means
와스
is that someone who is
유엔에 인지
heavy
유엔에
with
인지 와스
qualities, someone who has great
에
qualities.
어디 딘데질이야 안 고요레스
And so
딘데고
that's what guru should be
아
understood as
스파도
meaning.
마제 라마사티 라메
So, in
민바
brief,
제가 섬식 미뱀바 텔레야 안 고라
just being
고요레스
given the name of a
라마
guru doesn't help.
Korangi Tsingi Sangharabu Jidang
It's like the guru
Lame
has to have also have all the qualities and characteristics of a guru. They must have the qualities of a guru. It is important for the guru to have these qualities. Whether it is in the sutras or whether it is in the tantras, this is all said in all the different texts. In order to follow guru, you have to examine whether the guru is authentic or not. It's important to make this examination. And once you have found an authentic, genuine guru, it's important to follow them properly in both your thoughts and your actions. And the most important way to follow the guru is really depends upon your motivation. And that motivation is a saying in Chinese that means that. So if we are even as if you are mistaken at the beginning by just even a centimeter, at the end you may be mistaken by many kilometers. And so if in the beginning our mistaken is a little, our motivation is a little bit mistaken, then in the end, because the motivation for following the guru is mistaken, then in the end we have a lot of make a lot of mistakes in the way that we follow the guru. And so when we're searching for a guru, or when we're following a guru at all time, what's most important is our motivation. Many people think if maybe it'd be best if I find a kind of famous guru, and they take have this as their motivation, and when they search for a guru, others. They see many gurus have many students, and they think that the one who has many students must be better. And so they consider whether a lama is good or bad, depending upon whether they have a lot of students or not. And so, how they look at it, if there's someone who is kind of impressive when you look at them, or it seems like might they'd have powers, they think that that is better, then your mind gets attached to them. And so that's another way that people follow a guru. And so all of these, from the moment of looking for the guru, the motivation is not right. They don't have a pure motivation of wanting to practice the Dharma. Instead, they have various mixed motivations, good and bad. And then in the end, what happens is that when they follow the guru, they experience many difficulties. Because of this, many people say that they never meet good gurus, they only meet bad gurus. And the reason is maybe from one perspective, is that you can't just always blame other people. Sometimes this happens because your own motivation is mistaken. When you begin searching for the guru, you look for someone who's maybe a little bit well known, or someone who is handsome or good looking. And so even if you only have a little bit, even if it's not strong motivation, in the end, what the kind of guru that you find is one who, if the guru is well known, and because of that, and merely because of that, in the end, you always go to these famous gurus, however they are. Because in the back of your mind, you have this idea that maybe I'll meet a famous Lama. Even if you don't have a lot of attachment, if you have a little bit of attachment, then just by the influence of that, you'll naturally are going to end up following well-known gurus, and you can like going to see them. That's what happens, right? And this is primarily because of a distinction of your motivation. Now, you can't say that this is categorically bad, but it's the power of your motivation. It's like the influence of your motivation, that this influence does have this influence, and so it's important for us to be very careful. If we need to meet a good Lama and not a bad Karma, then it's important for us to be extremely careful about our motivation. If our initial motivation is even just slightly faulty, and we think that it's not good, we think that it's not important, but it's not like that. It's important for us to really be very, very careful and very assiduous. Sometimes we think that following a guru and practicing the Dharma so we wonder whether we can do that as carefully and assiduously as the other things that we do in our lives. For example, if we buy a thing today that is worth only $1, we think, oh, it's not very important, it's not that expensive, and so then we just don't really worry about it. And we just, you know, we all buy it, isn't it? It's not really easy to buy, so we think, and so we buy it with our eyes closed. But today, if we have to buy something that's gonna cost tens or hundreds of thousands of dollars, if we have to buy a thing like that, then we start to think a little bit. You know, we look at the both sides of it to see is it high quality? Do we like it or not? Should I buy it? Should I not buy it? We think about it a lot. And we think about it long, and then finally, and only after that do we buy it. Instead of, we don't just buy it immediately with our eyes closed. And the reason is because we have to, it goes to a lot of expense. You have to give a lot of money for it. And the more we have to do that, then the more careful we are in purchasing it. We spend more time, we have more care in our purchase. Similarly, when we're practicing the Dharma or following a guru, we talk about it, you know, from a large perspective. We're talking about the rest of this life and all our future lives. It's like everything in the future. We think about it in terms of the Dharma, there's absolutely nothing that's more important than that. There's nothing that's more significant than that. That's in terms of how it's taught in the Dharma. But really, when we actually think about how much mental effort do we put into it, how important do we really think about it? If we really examine that, it's like we don't really have the level of as much interest in it as we think. The way we speak about it, we say that it's easy to be say this is the most important. This is the there's nothing more important than this. But if you look at it, it's doubtful whether we have that same level of actual interest and actual care in taking in dealing with it. And so following the guru is something that's important. It's like one of the most important things in our lives, the most significant things in our lives. And if we then kind of ignore and think it's not important, then definitely then if we try to avoid such motivations and work hard and put a lot of care into it, then it will definitely work well. And so if we approach it this carefully like this, then it definitely work out properly. So today, the topic of our spring teachings is the 50 gurus. And so the reason we chose it is, as I mentioned, the first is that The way to follow the guru's spiritual friend is extremely important in the Buddhist teachings. Whether you're talking about Mahayana or foundation vehicle, in all the vehicles, the way to follow the guru is extremely important. And in particular, in the secret mantra Vajrayana, there all of the common and uncommon siddhis depend upon the guru. And so it's a really critical point to have an unmistaken way of following the guru. It's like the foundation of our practice of the Dharma. And so for this reason, when all the great beings of the past entered the practice of the Vajrayana, the foundation of this, or when they began their initial training, then they began by teaching the 50 verses on the Guru. And likewise, they would teach the 14 root downfalls of Samaya. And so for this reason, it's important for us to know how to follow a guru properly, and in particular, how to follow it in the secret mantra Vajrayana. But if we don't explain this properly, there's a real important point here. In general, these 50 verses on the guru, a few years ago, I spent a few months teaching this to a few people, so I gave instructions on it. And the reason we say this is sometimes there's a little bit, maybe our Tibetan, we Tibetans are a little bit better sometimes because we have like the good environment and we have the tradition and the customs, and so we, but if we have something different from that, we don't have an environment for practicing the secret mantra or for studying the secret mantra as among the Chinese or among the Westerners, and we teach the 50 verses for the guru, then it's like if we don't know how to teach the way to follow guru, then there's a real danger of misunderstanding. And some people, you know, intentionally say that they give incorrect explanations, and they say that they give instructions, and they say, you must follow the guru, you must do whatever the guru says, and they use it as a method to gather students and to gain control over the students and give wrong instructions. They give incomplete instructions. And give really strange instructions. And so for this reason, usually, I feel a little bit uncomfortable teaching about a topic like the 50 verses on the guru to such a large group, especially over the internet. So for that reason, I haven't taught it up till now. But the reason I'm teaching it now is, as I say, that the main people I'm teaching to are the nuns who have come to the spring teachings, as well as the monks and nuns in the monasteries and nunneries. So it's primarily for their sake that I'm giving the teaching. So this is the main, these are the main students for this teaching I'm thinking about. And so in this way, I think it's important for you to understand. That's one thing it's important for you to understand. If I say intended students, it's kind of a big term, but what I'm really saying is I'm teaching in particular to the monks and nuns from the monasteries. The other reason is I give as much of a complete and proper explanation. And so I shall try to do this. And because I'm making these efforts, there are also some Chinese students or Western students, people from all around the world who have faith, who if we give a complete explanation of what's taught in the it's actually taught in the Vajrayana, if they can say that an impartial and improper explanation would be like that, then I think if I teach them the full thing, When other people give improper
Yeah.
explanations or wrong explanations, they will not be influenced by that, and they won't be able to be deceived by that. And so I think there will be some benefit to that. So in any case, and so today, in particular for today, that's when I speak about this, sometimes it's not comfortable doing this. And the reason for this is because not comfortable for one reason is that I've been given the name of a guru. And so when I teach the 50 verses on the guru, I'm called a guru. And so I say, you should treat me like this. You should pay respect to me like this. You should think of me as really significant. And when I say this, it's a danger that it feels like this when I'm teaching that. Now, generally, when I don't have that motivation when I'm teaching. When I'm explaining, it's not thinking that I'm not thinking that I'm the guru, and therefore you have to think of me as important or as significant. I don't have the motivation of doing that in order to make myself good. I'm going to explain whatever is in the text. So it's in the middle, there's a little bit of discomfort for me, and the reasons of discomfort, I usually don't really teach about these topics. But sometimes even when you're uncomfortable, you have no choice but to teach this, as I mentioned before, because of the reasons I mentioned before. Sometimes even though it's not so comfortable, you still have to teach it. With our Tibetans, there's no question of it being uncomfortable or not, because we have the custom. It's like a tradition for us. So there's nothing under that. But for all the international students, if you look at it immediately, it's like they say, oh, he's a guru, and he's teaching about and saying that a guru is important and significant. And you're saying that you have to listen to what I say. And when I say that, they're going to wonder, what is he saying? It's possible you might think this. And so I thought it wouldn't be right not to explain this at the outset. So that's how it is. So that's the reason why we're speaking about the 50 verses on the guru. Now, in general, with the 50 verses on the Guru, there are Sanskrit manuscripts, there's a Chinese translation, and the Tibetan translation. There are the three translations. Now, we'll speak about the Sanskrit manuscripts later. So, and first, I thought it'd be best to start by speaking about the Chinese translation. There is an old translation of the 50 verses, and this is found in the Taisho Tripitaka. And in terms of that, that is given the catalog number of 1687. So the catalog number is 1687 in the Taisho Tripitaka. And it's listed, the author is listed as Master Ashvaghosha. Now the translator is listed as, is called Richeng. So Richeng, if you translate that into Sanskrit, it might be Ravikirti. It was like Dharmakirti. So similarly, we have Ravikirta, or famous son. So several masters, as led by Ravikirti, who translated. So this master Ravikirti, if you asked about who it is, who he was, he was during the Song dynasty in the Chinese. This is one of the Chinese dynasties in Chinese history, right? And so in the sixth year of the reign of the Song Emperor Renzong, which was in 1047 or 46. He came to the capital of Beijing at that time. His actual homeland was central India. He became a master there, and later in 1046, he went to the Bianlang, which was the capital of China at that time. And the emperor gave him the title of the Xunfan Master. If you translate this into Tibetan, you could translate it. It wouldn't mean much, and so it's better to just call him Xunfan Master.
lobe
And so he, at
chenje
that time,
wale ze shabe lobdu yorba oda
there
lobdu
is
da
the compendium of
tare
trainings by
yi
Shantideva,
kalo
right?
chi lelam
So he
jebe
translated that, as well as the sutra
dan
teaching the karmic
chese
paths of the ten
tale
non-virtues and other texts.
ti na ne lama
He
ngu du ma
translated
di
several texts. Among
kong
them,
shabe da chwezin chi cha de yore
the 50
ane kong
verses of the
dang
Guru is
shabe
one
me
Dharma
jebe
text that he translated.
jeba cheng xun sa kuni ane chobu
There was also a
sepa
monastic from Chinshin who came from Japan, and he was very close to Lhabakirti. In any case, that the Chinese translation of the Chinese translation of the 50 verses was translated during the Sung dynasty, and it could have even been translated a little bit earlier than the Tibetan translation by Rinchen Sangpo. So, and the translation was from the Sanskrit into Chinese. So that is a brief history of the Chinese translation of the 50 verses. Now, regarding the Tibetan translation of this, we have several different tenjur editions of the tenjur, and later the most important one of these is the Derje tenjur. In terms of the Derje tenjur, it's in the volume two of the tantras. In terms of the catalog number, the Tohoku catalog, it's D3721. In the Derje Tenjuru, the author of the 50 verses is listed as Master Ashvaghosha, and the translators were was translated by the Indian scholar Padmakar Varma and pictured ancient Sampo, and they too translated and discussed it and finalized the translation. Later, it says that also there's a later translation by Chat Lotawa. Chat Lotawa, Chat the translator. It could have been Chalo Rinchen Dingadutan, Chalo Rinchen Chiyal, or the other one is named, there's another Chak. There are two translators who are called Chat Lotaman. So I don't know when it was translated or who it was, but in which it was, but there is a different translation by Chakotsa that is mentioned in Jason Kampa's commentary on the 50 verses. So in Tibet, there are at least two different verses. One of these is the one I was just mentioning by Lotawa Richard Sampa, and the other is the translation by Chak Lotawa. But I've never seen a Takata. It's possible that it's extant these days, but I've never seen a copy of it. Likewise, in Tibetan, we have not just the root text of the 50 verses of the Guru, but we also have a Sanskrit commentary on the 50 verses. And this was translated into Tibetan by Gulotsawa Shunupel. So this is an Indian commentary that's translated by Gulotsawa Shunupel. And this is called the commentary on the different points of serving the Guru. And so this is also in the Tenjura, the Derje Tenjura. You have first of the 50 verses on the Guru, and then after that you have the commentary on the difficult points of serving the Guru. The question is, who is the author of the commentary? As I say, it's written by an Indian scholar, an Indian master. So who is that Indian scholar? Some say that it is the Pandit Nagi Rinchen, the Tibetan name. There are some people who say this, but this is probably not quite right. And the reason for this is that if we look at the colophon to the commentary on the difficult points itself, what it says is that the commentary on the difficult points, the 50 verses, is completed, with some bits of Sanskrit gained through the kindness of the great scholar Pal Nakyarinshan from the east of India. I, Shunupal, translated this at the glorious exalted Guru's retreat place above the temple. So this is what it says. So if we look at this, the commentary on the 50 verses
네 듀라보 나 디기 다시 디츠기 카팅이 어르잖아 당기
What
콘디션이 디기
these words
그걸로
say is
쓰는데
that the
프랑 데네
translator of the
디기
commentary on the 15th
데네
goes
디기 링자르토 세토
learned
온스토
some
저 디기
Sanskrit
디바디
from the Indian
네네
master
바이
Nakayon
바이
Rinchen. It
인세데
doesn't say
그
that that Nakayon Rinchen actually wrote this
아는 지기
commentary.
사마르챵아 최다가 제샤베기 인고로 디기
Likewise,
남타지오
there's also
사마르챵아 최다가
a
사마르챵아
story of the Golotoa's life. So this is
사마르챵아
a
시바 코랑
by the Shamar Chenga
고기
Chögyalpa, who is the
로로
fourth Shamar.
다
He
공기
was a direct disciple
제샤베기
of
윤데르바 윤데르 무지슈
Golotoa
제샤베
Shinarpa.
공디시오레
So he wrote a life story of
이남
him called The
남수
Supremely Spreading
어르잖아
Tree of Precious Qualities.
까망인
Now, what
구
it says in
일단데
there is that
제샹
this
메바 제샹
commentary on the
메바
difficult points of
제다
following the
나네
guru
인구
has no
가르쳐드는 제샹
colophon.
요마르 제바부 수인 세브
Since
요마르
there's no author's qualifying,
이
it's saying that
근절
the
제비다
author is unknown. And if we
가다
look at
구르
this,
즈미베기 굴나샤베기
then it says that the
나네
commentary
인구 간제디
on the
제바부
difficult
수인
points
세브기
of the 50
세브야
verses on the guru is written by an anonymous author.
Tātātā lāmeññiṅ gūrgī gāndhī yorba, lāmeññiṅ gūrgī gāndhī tīn nālōlayā,
And so
tātī
this
tōṅ
commentary on
tōṅ
the
yorba,
difficult points of
tātī tīyā,
finding has a slightly
rīñcē
different root
sāmbayi
text.
gyūrnā sāyabayi, tātī tītā, tōtōs mañrā yōndī
It's
tōs.
a little bit different than
Tī
Rigen
tīyā
Sampo's
gōsī
translation
tītā,
of the root
tātā
text.
līcār
So
gī
if we look at
lāmeññiṅ gā,
this,
tātī nīsī yorba, tī
there are
gōsī
probably
tōtōs
two
nīsī,
different manuscripts
tātā līcār gī yāba mīñrā nīsī yorba, tātā
of the
yāng tātī
Sanskrit. And so I think that because there are
nāda
different
xīng
differences
tōtō
in
līcē
this,
sāmbayi tētāyān jīg tūma tūnru
so there are
kāngyē tūnru
issues of there's different places of whether they match the translation by Rinchen Sampo or
tāntarā
not.
tātā
In any
gyāngyōgī
case,
ngōlu
this
shūgyō gyūrnāsāba
Indian
gyāngdēbī
commentary that was
jīn
translated
tōngkā
by
tātā
Golotsawa
jīn
Shinupa.
tōngkā bēgī lāmaṅgabzhū bēgī dēba tsaṁnāmbī kāblīyā pājī gyāngdēdī sīgī yusamārē tī sīgī yabā tī jīn tōngkā pājī
When it
gyāngdēbī
was not read
gyūrnāsāba
by
gyāngdēbī
Jay Tsongkhapa
yusamārē
before he wrote his
tātā jīn
commentary on this,
sārsē
if you look at
lōsē
the two together, you see
gyātsōgī
that it was. There's also a
ngōlu
commentary by Tsarchen Lhoso
yōsī
Gyatso.
dēshābēgī lāmaṅgabzhū bēgī yāre tī nālōlīyā
So in his commentary on the 50 verses,
lāmaṅgabzhū bēgī gyāngdēbī dēshābēgī yāre tī pājī sīgī yāre
it
tī
seems that he
tāngī
had
yāba
not read
rāngyōrē
this
jīn tōngkhā
Indian
dēshābēgī
commentary. So in general,
lāmaṅgabzhū ngōgū
when Jay
jīn
Tsongkhapa
rōngwā
was 59
jīn
years
kōshī
old, or
jīnyā
that's in
rōlīyā
in the
jīnyā
autumn
rōlīyā
of
bēgī
1415,
and Jay Tsongkhapa bēlōm nīgyā tsam and wē
one
jī
Dr.
tāshī
Mjesen
jāyā
invited Jay
rōlīyā
Tsongkhapa and 200
shūbēgī
disciples to
kāblīyā
Ongi Tashi Dōka
tāni gōlō
Monastery.
shūnūbēgī
And when they were
gōlō shūnū
staying
Jay
there,
Tsongkhapa pājī jēbī
Guru Lhotshe
tāni
Shinobang
tāma
met
jī
Tsongkhapa for the very
jī
first time.
tāni gōlō
And at that
shūnūbēgī
time,
Jay Rōmjī gundyūnyā
Guru
Jay Rōngwā
Lhotshe
sēngbā tāni
Shinobang received
jēne
many Dharma teachings
lāmaṅgabzhū bā
from
dzōdōng gī nāmchī
Tsongkhapa.
lāmaṅgabzhū bā
And among them were
jē
the 50
gundyū bā
verses
jē
on the
sēngbā
guru
jē lāmaṅgabzhū
and the
bēgī
explanation of the root downfalls
tāni
from
dzōdōng
him.
gī nāmchī jē sū sēngbā yīnsī
And so he
jē sū chū
received these teachings from
jē jē tōnggō lō shīngbā
Tsongkhapa, as it
pājī
said.
gundyūnyā nā kōnggō sēngbā dzōdōng mā sēbē ān chī sū
Not
chēyā
only
bā
did he
yīnā
study them with
chēnyē
Tsongkhapa,
kāshē nā yuwa
he
bā tī
also later
lāmaṅgabzhū bā
taught it
jē sā
himself
bē
times, as
gundyūnyā nā kōnggō
clear
lō shīngbā
in
pājī sēbē
Samar's
yīnsī
biography of Golotsawa.
tēlē yā tēbī nā ān pājī
So when I look at
gōlō
this, I
shīngbā
think that
bēgī lāmaṅgabzhū
probably
gī gundyū
Golotsawa
nāmbē tē
Shinupal probably
jē
translated
tōnggō
this
bē
commentary on the
gundyūnyā
difficult points
lāmaṅgabzhū bā sēng sārvē jēlē yā
after he had already
gundyūnāsāba
studied the
jēntō
50
sōngbā
verses
tā
with
pājī
Jay Tsongkhapa.
tā tōbaru jī
I think he
tōngbō
must have translated later. This is my doubt.
tā kēnē hēlē yā lāmaṅgabzhū bēgī jēbā jīg chā chēwā rō kārī kārī yō rā chī
Now,
sēbē
if you wonder
pājī tā
what are the
kēnē jī
most well-known Tibetan commentaries on the 50 verses on the Guru,
sōrū gyab tūmā sōndī yīnē yā tā
I was unable to
lāmaṅgabzhū
make a list of all of them, but
bēgī
in
tīmā
general,
sōndī tā
among
tōngā
the
shē rū
Tibetan
jīgī jīgī
commentaries on the 50
tōngnāng wē
verses,
kēnē
the earliest
lāmā
was
kēnzhēng zhē shā bē kī
the
lāmā
one
tēmbē
by
tōngnāng lāmā
Jacen
ngā
Dabha
zhū bē sēmē chā
Gyatso's
chī
elucidation of the
nīng xū
50
jī
verses of the Guru.
tātā yuè bē nāng lō nīng xū jī miāng rō sōng sōng rō chī tō
This, I think, is
tāmē xīng
the
jī tōngbō
oldest
chē bā
of the
chā shā
extant
bē kī
commentaries.
lāmā ngā zhū bē dūdēng shā
There's
chī
also a
dūdēng shā
summary
chī
of the 50
tātā
verses on
yuè
the
nīng
Guru
xū
by
jī
Drogo
tōngbō
Chögyal Palpa. This is also among the
nīng
oldest
xū jī tāng jī bā chā tātā nē
among the oldest
tā
Tibetan
nī
commentaries.
Rā yūr mā pā lā tsā wē kī, ngō chūgū tō jī kī sē,
There's also a commentary by Ngotshidan Dorje, the son of Marpa, the translator's direct disciple, Ngotchuko Dorje. It's said that there was a commentary by him, but I have not seen it yet. There are also commentaries among them, within one famous one is Jetsongkhapa's commentary called Fulfilling All the Students' Wishes, an explanation on the 15 verses on the Guru. And after that, then there is also, among the later lamas, there's in terms of the Karmakamsan, there is the seventh Karmapa Chöden Jatso's annotations on the 50 verses on the Guru. Likewise, there is the Tsachen Lhasa Gyatso, who among the Sakya women, the Tsar Ngo and Kun Sun, he's in the Tsar tradition, he's like the founder of the Tsar tradition. The Tsachen Lhasa Gyatso wrote a commentary called Opening the Gateway to Precious Accomplishment, a commentary on the 50 verses of the Guru. Likewise, it's said that there's a commentary by the Mahasira Lingje Repa, but I haven't seen that. And there are many other commentaries. Most of them are from the Gelugpa tradition, it seems. It seems like there are more commentaries on the 50 verses from the Gelugpa tradition. So that's how that is. Now, when we speak about the 50 verses on the Guru, now what it says in Jetsun Drapa Gyaltsen's elucidation of the 50 verses on the Guru, it says that it's taught by five general points. And I thought this was good. I said, kind of, if we understood it, this was very easy to understand. And so what it says is that, it's not, so I said there are three, but actually there are five general points. There are five general points in the Buddha. He said to teach in terms of 5 points what these are. First, there's who is the author of the text? Who wrote the text? So interesting, who wrote it? The second, since it's a Vajrayana text, so what tantras is it based on? And the second is the reason why he wrote it. What was the purpose for writing it? The fourth is when should this taught to be taught? What is the time when you should teach the 50 verses on the Guru? And the last one is the summary. This is the actual explanation of the text. So it said this is good to teach it through these five general points. And I thought these would make it easy to understand. So among those five different points, the first one is the author of the text. Basically, to explain it, saying, who wrote the text, the 50 verses on the Guru? And you say, who wrote the 50 verses on the Guru? And this is actually kind of complicated. And there are several different explanations of who the author of the 50 verses is. The two main ones, the most common one is that it's written by Ashvaghoshan, as well there is by the master Babila. Some people say, well, Ashvaghoshan himself is a Babila. So sometimes they're identified as being the same person, just different names. These are different names for different types of them, but in actuality, it's one person. There are some people who recognize them as being the same person. However, I think it's probably better to say that they're actually different individuals, but Ashvaghosha and Babila are actually different people. And the reason for this is that the Master Babila and Ashvaghara, their life stories are a little bit different. They're kind of different, so. Some Japanese scholars say that the 50 verses were probably written during the end of the time that the teachings were spreading, and particularly after the teachings on the unexcelled Yoga Tantra had spread. And Master Ashvaghosha is, some people say he was from the 2nd century of the Common Era. Some people say that he was in the 5th or 6th century, but in any case, He was from an earlier time. He was a master from an earlier period, and so for this reason, if you look at the meaning taught in the 58 verses, it must have been a text written after the secret Mantravajrayana teachings had spread. The reason for this is that if you look in the 49th stanza of the 50 verses, then make them a receptive vessel by giving them mantras and so forth. Make them recite and memorize the 14 root downfalls. So here, because it's teaching the 14 root downfalls of Samaya, then it's clear that it must have appeared after the unexcelled yoga tantra had spread. And so for this reason, it's difficult to say that it would have been written by Master Ashvaghosha. Now, as I mentioned before, Jitsun Drakajasan wrote the elucidation on the 50 verses of the Guru. As I mentioned, this is the earliest of the extant Tibetan commentaries on this. So Jitsun Drakajasan was one of the five Sakya forefathers, as I mentioned earlier, right? And when it says, when he speaks about who the author is, he says it's a Bhavila. He says this master Bhavila was from the caste of the caste of King Chandra. He was born from a royal family. So in the kings, there used to be the moon caste and the sun caste. He was from the moon or Chandra caste. He gave up his role of power and went to Nalanda monastery to go forth as a monastic. His gurus were Jatari and Sudana. And he became a great pandit at that time, but he wasn't given actually the title of this. He wasn't given this. It seems that this had to have been given by a king, but the king, because he was not given the actual title. He left Nalanda and went to the eastern part of India, to Bengal, it is said. Some people say that he... According to a different account of Master Bhavila's life, it said that he was different. And what's different is it says that at first he was a non-Buddhist scholar. He was originally a non-Buddhist scholar, and then he later converted to be a Buddhist scholar. So this is another explanation. In any case, there are different explanations of the first half of his life. The first is that he went forth as a monastic, as a Buddhist monastic, and the second is that he first was a non-Buddhist and then became converted to Buddhism. So there are these two different explanations. In any case, he went to Bengal. So he went from the central India to the east of Bengal. And when he was there, near Bengal, there is a place called the Dharma of the Land. It's called it. It's probably a statue of Tara that was made out of sand. And when he was making And when he was there making offerings to it, there's a land near the Jambudvipa. So this is when we're speaking about Jambudvipa as India. There's an island near that called Chuta. So this is what we call the continent or the land of India, of Jambudvipa. And then there is India that was called the land of Chuta. And so the people on this island only had one leg. And when they had to walk, you had two people had to walk together. Because each person only had one, they couldn't go on their own. But did two people go together? They had to work together and use some sort of like a machine to a contraption. And so while he was, so he was making. So he thought that he had to go to make offerings to the statue of Tara built by Chandragoma. And when he, on the way there, the people from the land of from the island of Chuta, who only had one arm, these people came in ships. And they arrived at the same place as he did. And when they saw a person with two legs, they'd never seen anyone with two legs, and so that this is really amazing. And so they abducted him and they took him away. And so where this island of Chuta is seems pretty amazing. If it's real or not, I don't know. Sometimes it's hard to tell. You know, the land where people only have one leg, this is kind of strange. It's kind of. However, but when we, I don't know whether you've seen this, but it's mentioned in the final elucidation of the Sakya tradition. I don't know if you've seen it. For example, it's when you, what it says is if you do a ritual, you have to do it properly. It's like if you go to the land of Chuta, they consider someone with two legs not to be a human. For example, because people in Chuta only have one leg, when they see someone coming who has two legs, they think that they don't even think that it's human. But so there must be this land of Chuta, and I haven't related, but it's this kind of amazing sort of land. In any case, the people from Chuta, they helped him and they took him. He went. They helped him to go to this statue. They helped him go there, and he spent some time doing practicing there. But this is probably in a place where the Dharma had not spread. And he thought, there's no point in me staying there. So I probably need to go back to my homeland. And when I go back to my own homeland, then I can benefit sentient beings. So this is what he intended to do. But they wouldn't let him go. When he was brought over, the people from Chuta had helped him get to that island, but he couldn't go back. And he didn't know how to get back. So he prayed to Tara. Since he was near the statue of Tara, he prayed to Tara. And he's praying to Tara then. And one night he had a dream. In which he received a prophecy from Tara, and Tara said to him in the dream, think about where you want to go in your mind. Think about the land you want to go in your mind. Think about that. And then thinking that you're going there with that kind of impulse, and then lie down with your head and pointing in the direction of where you want to go. This is the direction that she gave him. So when Tadak made that prediction in the dream, and he, since he thought about the land, he thought about it in his mind, that I'm going there. He had that motivation, and he lay down with his pillow pointing in his head pointing in the direction of the land where he wanted to go. The next morning, when he woke up, he had arrived at that place on the other side of the ocean. So he had to cross the ocean, right? Instead of having to cross the ocean in a boat, when he woke up, he was there. He had already reached his destination. It seems that he probably had arrived in Nalanda, which is in the central India, right? So he went to Nalanda, and when he got there, there had been a lot of changes in Nalanda, because when he was young, Nalanda, all the panditas, old scholars, the older scholars, had mostly passed away already. And when he was there, he had some pupils who had new students who had been teaching, and they had all become panditas. And so when this happened, he looked and he got there during that period of time. He's like, he didn't have an opportunity to benefit other people because all his friends from before had mostly passed away. The people who were the new students when he was there, the new monks, now had all become panditas. And so he probably, there was probably no one there whom he really knew. And so for this reason, he thought to himself, well, I can't benefit anyone else. And he was a little bit depressed about this. But he was also a bit
these truth.
annoyed by
And
it.
then Kongi,
He got
yeah, he
angry
kept
over it.
studying.
And so what he did was,
That gives a gives about the lela was a chevy,
I
Nedig.
tried to explain it in
Nga
simple
kong yu bali ya
terms,
tene sayu
because
yala
of
tinje nga kong yu bali tene sayu
he used a
yala tinje
mantra to
kong yu chale lo
cause an
sayu
earthquake there. So
sayu
he did the ritual to this, and he had created
nga kong yu bali chi tene
an
sayu tetchu
earthquake. And because of
sayu
this,
kyeje sane
and when he did
sayu kyeje
the
branch bali
earthquake,
ye kang
his own resident at the
ma bali
bottom, the building that he was
tene
staying,
kang bo chen
that
da ma chen bo
collapsed.
chi kwaran shu su
And of
jiwa
course, all the other ones, his own residence still
ane ma
destroyed.
na chen kasang ma kwaran
In the
Longa
past, when he
Shengi,
had been,
Sudeling,
the people from Chuta who
Sudeling,
had helped him,
Tao
it was the people from
Tizu,
Chuta who had
Yuan
helped him get to the Tara statue.
Shengi,
And so many animals and
Tuchi,
humans from that place
Tuda
were
Tang Tuchi Xia, Tinde Chungi Sirwa.
also died in the earthquake.
Chene, Ta Kong Diz Kong La Dian Chene, Do Si,
And so because of
Yuan Dong
him,
Chungi Sirwa. Tela
there was a
Dian
lot of
Chene,
destruction. He
Ta
caused a lot of destruction. And because
Kong
of
Chi
this,
Ya, Milang Na Lo
and
Ya,
one night he
Dwe
had in a dream,
Dwe Me Lung Ya,
Tara
Ta
came and
Kong Chi
made
Ten Ta
another
Midi Me Mangbo
prosper.
Xie Jeba Jeba Jeba
President.
Magong Me Zhu Kare Sa Na Zude Ling Sa Da Ko Ta Rung Bo Xie
And he
Jeba
probably
Jeba
didn't realize that he'd killed so many people because
Da Yi Na Yang Ta
the land
Chuta
of
Ye Jeba Nga
the island
Ye
of
Bo
Chuta was
Sa
so
Ye Bo
far out.
Ta
But
Bin
when he
Du
got
Sa
angry,
Ta
he
Mo Go
made
Ti
that
Xie
earthquake and destroyed
Sa
many
Ha Ha Su Ye
houses
Be Mi Da Tun Ru Mangbo Xie Le An Ka
and
Ye
killed many,
Xi Me Gong
gave a
Bo
lot
Se
of
Ta Xia Ling
difficulties
Na
to,
Dwe Me
and
Mi
killed a
Lung Na
lot
Lo
of
Dwe Me
people
Lung
and
Ya
animals from
Ta
different
Kyorang Ne Ten Ti Wa Chi Bu
people.
Se Zi Sen Ba
So
Ji Ye
Tara
Ji
came
Ne
to
Re
him
Si
in a dream and said, "You, in the past, you're like
Kyorang
a,
Ne
supposed
Lega
to be a
Che Gu
Mahayana
Ye Gu Wa
practitioner.
Lega Che Gu Yuwa Ra Ti
The
Ya Ti
work
Ma
you should
Ten
be
Ji
is to
Ze Zi Ta
benefit of the
Ti Ren Po Chi
sentient
Le Ne Ti
beings, but
Ji
instead of doing that, you've harmed a whole lot of sentient
Ren
beings.
Ju Sa Ne
And
Ani
so for
Kyorang
that
Si Ten Lu
reason,
Bang Be Ge Nye Ba Yung Gu Re Ten Ji Yin Ju Kyorang
you
Ti Ma
have
Chi Gu
the
Ye Si
wrong of giving up on
Ji Ji Gu
sentient
Ne Na
beings, and so you need to confess.
Ti
So
Lu
this
Ne
is the
Na Yin Ju
instruction
Sa
she
Na Ta
gave
Lu
him.
Kyorang Ki Ye Ta
And when
Ta
she
Ti Ren Ti
did,
Ji
and the
Ye Ta
master
Lu
thought,
Kyorang
I thought, "Oh,
Ta
that
Xia Ba
wasn't
Ti Ru
good.
Gong Ma Re Si
I need to
Xia Ba
go
Ti Ru
make
Gong
a
Ta Xia
confession."
Bu
So
Xia
he
Ba
thought,
Ti Sa
"Well,
Ru Bu Ti
so he
Ji
thought,
Ji
well, who should I make the
Ma Ji Xia
confession
Ba Ti
to?
Ru
What's
Gong
the
Ma Xiong
best
Su Ye
what's the
Yana Ru
best
Zi
place to
Sa
make a
Re Ya Ma
confession?"
Ban Jia Bei Yang Wu
And he
Su
thought he would go to the
Ta
five peak mountain
Ta
Wu
Ti
Tai
Ri
Shan in China
Ta Ji
and
Xia
confess to
Ying Yin Sa
Manjushri.
Ta Ti Gun Du Lian Xin Xie Ne Bei Bi
And
Guan
so he
Xia Wei
thought,
Ti
well,
Yang
I
Wu Nian
should,
Ru Xie
and so
Jie
maybe it'd
Ti
be
Ri Gong
best for
Bo
me to
Xie Ye
go
Ya
to
Ru Jiang
Manjushri
Jie
there and
Jie
make a
Jie Ru
confession
Jiang
there.
An
And then
Chuan
once
Ban
again,
Jiao Ru
Tara
Jiang Ta
said,
Ti De Xin Ji Ji
"If
Xia
you
Ba Ti
go
Ye
to
Xia Ti
Wu
Ti Ji
Tishan
Ge Ba Ban
in
Ru Ge
China
Xi An Chuan Ban Jiao Ru San Na
and
Sang
confess there, that
Ar
won't
Shu
help. That's not what you should do. What you should do is you should
Chuan Ge Ji
engage
Xin
in
Bu Qi
mantra
Yin Bu
practice.
Qin Bu Qi
You've
Yin
done a
Sang Ar
huge
Yin Gong Ma
misdeed,
Ru
and so
Bu
for that
Qi
reason,
Ar
unless
Shu
you
Xie
engage in mantra practice, you won't be able to
Rao Le
purify it.
Ar Shu Xie Ma Re Na Kan Da Qie Ne Ar Shu Chuan Ge Di Ba Ta Ge Qie Du Ka Ri Qie
It's
Wa
not that you should enter the practice.
Sang
What you
Ar
need
Le
to do,
Ju
she
Xie
says,
Le Tang Bu Ba Ti Ju Tuan Da Le
is
Ya
that you should do something for the
Zhe Zhe
benefit
Zhang
of
Wu
new
Ka
people
Ri Zhang Wu Ru
who are
Zhe Zhe Wu
entering
Qie Tang
the
Sang Ba Lu
Vajrayana.
Ju Bei
What you need to do is
Zhang
write texts. You should recite
Ji
two
Ji Mang Bu
texts.
Le
One is the
Jia Ba Zhang
50
Wu Ru Xie
verses on the Guru,
Zhe Zhe
and
Ji Mang Bu Le
also on
Ma
the
Le Zhu
root
Ge
down
Meng
of
Ge Lu Ge
Vajrayana.
Nang Ba Nang
You have to
Xie
write
Ne
commentaries on many
Zhe Le Ge Meng Ge Yi
Vajrayana tantras.
La Mang Ngub Ju Ba Tang
And
Da
so for
Le
that
Zhu
reason,
Ge
then the
Zhe Meng
master
Ge
of the
Nang Xie
50 verses on the
Da
Guru,
Le Xi Cha La
the
Ba Lu Guang
explanation
Xie Ji Tang
of the root
Ma Le Zhu
downfalls,
Zhu
as
Ge
well
Yi
as
Tang
the
Tang Nang Ngan Jia Tang
commentaries on the empowerment of
Zhu Ge Ding
Vajrayana,
Ji Tang
the
Do Ji Tang
Suddhakara
Ge Jie Guang
Tantra,
Do Ji
the
Ta Sang
Abhibodhi
Ta
of
Tai Ji
Virochana,
Gyu Ba
the
Be
Union of the
Jia Ba
Buddhas, the Four
Jin Ji Ye
Seats, the
Si
Vajradhakini, and the Chakrasamvara
Da Ji
Tantras. And this is what it says.
Da Ji Ne Hoa Bin Ba Bi Le Si Ha Te Le Ya Kurang Le
And
Cien
then
Xi
this
Da Ji
master,
Ju
Babilaya,
Cien
was
Xi
also
Da Ji
called
Ge
by a
Ta
different
Su Bu
name,
Si
which
Na Ta Su
was
Bu
called the Three
Ta Su Bu Si
Deity.
La Gua Yin Zheng Ka Re Sa Na Kurang Ki
Well, it's called Three Deities because he
Ta
had
Sum De Neng Yu Si Nam Gyu
it's because
Ru
he
Ji Chen Pa Ru Zu Sum De
had
Neng
three main Yidam
Yin Ka Re
deities.
Sa Na Cha Ge Chen Bu Ru
One
Ga
of
Ji
these
Ji Ma Ru Ge
was
Ji Xie Xie
the
Chi Tang Ji
Chakrasamvara
Si
as
Ru
a
Ga Ji
special
Ma Xie
deity
Tang
for
Ge Ba Ji Xie
practicing
Wu Ji
deity.
Wa Xie Xie
Tara as a special deity
Ben
for
Chuo
removing
Da Yuan Ma
external
Dang Yu
obstacles,
Si
and the and Achala as the special deity for
Yi Da Bu
removing
Ma Zu
inner
De Neng
obstacles.
Yu Si Ru Di
So,
Ji
and
Zhen Jie
basically, he
Ta
followed as
Guang
his
Liang Ta
main
Su Bu
Yidam
Si
deities, Chakrasamvara, Tara, and Achala. And
Zhe
so he
Yang
was called
Da Bu Ma Zu
Three
Xie
Deity. So, this
Ta
is
Da
why it
Xin
was called
Ge Ne Ta Da
Three
Lo Ren
Deity.
Ba Bi La Xia Te Dang Lo
Three
Ren Xia
Deity.
Be Cha Bu Xue Xio Ru Yang
Like, also, there was
Lo Ren Xia
a
Be Cha Bu
master
Xue
named
Jia Ma Ru Be
Master
Zhe Qing
Manjushri
Ji Ji
Kirti, who
Ji
was
Jie Jia Re
a very great
Ru Da Ngan Su
Indian
Ge Ma
master,
Ru
master who
Ta Ma
wrote
Bu Rong Jun Do Ji Gin Zhe Xia Be Sang Ar
wrote a
Ju Bu
text on the root five
Guang
downfalls
Liang
of Samaya.
Tian Ju Hong Zi Ge Su Xie Xio Ru Ba Ti Tong Zi Ge
There
Xia
is
Du
And the text by the Karmapa Raja Dorje on the fruit root death is based upon the text by Manjushri Kirti, as it is said. In any case, Manjushri Kirti and Master Babila were both very well known as being very learned. In any case, Master was among one of the more well known of Indian masters. In any case, this is the individual who is the author. This is a this is what is taught, and Jetsun Drapa Jatsun's commentary. So when we look at his story and the life story of Ashtragosha, they're a little bit different. So I think that actually it's better to say, instead of saying that they're one individual, I think that it's better to say that they're different individuals for many different reasons. And I think that I can actually say more about this later. So I think it's probably better to leave there today. So I think it's just good that we have just begun. Sometimes it's difficult to start teachings. Often there are impediments. The other day I caught a cold, and I still haven't completely read it. Before that, I was extremely busy. Before that, I had a cold. And after getting the cold, I didn't have the time to rest, and then because of that, and it took a long time to get over it, and because of that, I was kind of wondering would I be able to give a teachings, but today I think it's okay. I think it's all right. So I'd be able to begin the teaching today, and so by just beginning, we've accomplished half of our purpose. So next, we have another 10 days or so, over 10 days. So I think that we will not have many obstacles in this teaching from now on. So I think it's best to leave it here today. So please recite the dedications and aspirations.